humble women I'd ever met. She wasn't just a great priestess, she was a great human being. She was lovely to be around, her presence was heartwarming. And heartwarming, I think, is something very important when you talk about Doreen Valiente. Gavin and I went down to Brighton. I'd been visiting him, he lived in London at the time, and of course I'm now married to him after Stuart's death. And I wanted to show him some of the craft, the people he'd never met. Well, first of all, I took him to meet another priestess, quite well known, and we visited her, and afterwards I said to Gavin, well, what did you think of her? And he said, I wasn't impressed. So I said, do you want to meet Doreen? And he said, I would love to. And I said, I can't get hold of her at the moment. I haven't got her phone number on me. We'll have to take a chance. So the next day, Gavin, who had a huge great motorbike, loaded me up as a biker, and the two of us set off in the pouring rain for Brighton. And it was cold, and it was wet, and it was miserable, and it was dark. Well, we arrived in the rain. It was bucketing down. At the same time, Doreen and Ron, who was her high priest, had obviously been out somewhere, and they pulled up in Doreen's little car. Now, Doreen hadn't learnt to drive for very long, so she was kind of a little bit all over the place, but I recognised the car, and I said, Doreen is here. We've met her. We can go and see her. So we climbed off the motorbike. Now, you've got to remember, I looked like a biker in all this gear, and Ron had a walking stick, and on the top of the walking stick was a huge chunk of amber, but concealed under the amber was a massive, massive piece of iron. And his idea was that if anyone went near Doreen, he would just wallop them and probably lay them out flat. So he saw these two bikers coming towards Doreen, and his hand tightened on the staff, and Doreen just glared at us. And I yelled through the pouring rain, Doreen, Doreen, it's me, it's Janet Farrer, and took the helmet off, and she went, oh my dears. Oh, you're soaking wet. Do come in. So we went up to her flat and she turned on the gas fire for us. And she said, I insist I'm taking all your wet clothes and I'm going to put them on the radiator or whatever by the gas fire to dry. She said, you can't go out in that. She said, I'm going to put you up at a friend of mine's for the night. I'm not letting you drive back to Portsmouth, because Gavin lived in Portsmouth and we said we'd driven down from there. She said, no, you're not going back in that. She said, you're going to stay right here in Brighton where it's nice and warm. Well, we said, no, 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 we will be fine. You don't have to put us up, because she'd actually put myself and Virginia up once before and we didn't feel that was right or fair. After all, Portsmouth wasn't too far away. But the rain was beginning to die down, so we reassured her. She was in the kitchen making cups of tea, slices of cake and everything else. And she chatted to Gavin, who she'd never met before, like an old, old friend. After that, when Gavin moved to Ireland, she would phone us up sometimes and we would talk for hours on the phone. She didn't approve of training in witchcraft covens. She said, oh, it wasn't like that in my day. We didn't have training. We just got into the circle and we did it. But on the other hand, she was quite happy that Gavin was running a training coven. But after that day, when we got back to Portsmouth, I said to Gavin, I said, well, what did you think of her? And his expression was wonderful. He said, she is a real priestess. There are no airs and graces on her. What you see is what you get. She is concerned and considerate for other people's well-being. That is a lady, a real lady. And she is one of the finest priestesses and one of the finest ladies, one of the finest women I've ever come across. That was Doreen Valiente.